I'm not usually one to give out my sources, but if any of you guys want to stay up to date with all of the E3 coverage as being done by Nintendo, you can head on over to press.nintendo.com. The username is Nintendo, and the password is E3 2014. Make sure the N in Nintendo is capitalized, as with the E in the password. And you can access all the press packages and press kits that are being offered to actual journalists. And you can get a look at all the new screenshots and footage and possibly leaked information that hasn't yet been revealed to the public. We're back with another episode of Perfect Dark. In the last episode, we did Area 51 Infiltration, which is a pretty friggin' fun level. And now we're going to do Area 51 Rescue, which I teased as having a rather interesting and unique approach to the mission, because you can do it one of two ways.
The problem you have is that there is no way to sneak into the research section. The only way in available to you...
So, of course, this is Agent Jonathan, who is undercover, trying to recover this friend we're trying to get at. He's explaining the premise of this mission.
Doesn't sound like a problem to me. Where are these explosives?
In that crate.
Jonathan's explaining that inside of this crate, it can be hovered, and it carries explosives inside. Now, what you have to do is escort this box to the explosion point in order to progress further in the mission, and if you let the crate explode, you'll fail the mission. So, a really big boon to doing well in this mission is, of course, shielding the crate. You can press the B button to hold on to it, and we'll see right here. Ooh. Here we go. I have no idea how much easier or harder this is going to be with the two joysticks. Ooh, this is probably where the game's going to start getting hard. Ooh, okay. Alright, that's fine. Alright, let's see here.
What the hell? Let's
shoot that guy.
Oh my god!
Okay. Alright, cool. Alright. We're doing well for ourselves so far. A lot of this really is about the stealth of it. So we'll leave this crate here and we'll go back here. Because there's something... If we can keep these guys from firing their weapons, we'll remain hidden. Since the silencer is only loud enough to hear in a very short range. So if we can get through the bottom floor without having anyone fire off their loud friggin' dragons... We should be okay, meaning we can get up to the next floor without being detected. Let's see. Is there anyone else down here? Crap! Ah! You son of a gun! Well, no point staying hidden now. Alright, let's see here. Let's take these guys out. They're gonna ride the elevator down here now. So now we've gotta be careful. We can't take the cube with us yet. Not quite yet. Alright. Alright, no. You stay open. There we go. Because now we gotta go grab our cube again here. There we go. Whoa! Okay. See, the best thing to do is always to leave the cube behind if you're in combat. And just, like, keep the guards away from it. Because they'll never aim at it. But, you know. If you're leaving it open. Get over here. God. No. Stay open. Thank you. There we go. Alright, we gotta grab the cube. It's an escort mission, but, like, the worst kind. Because it's not even gonna follow you around. It's not gonna auto-follow you. Which is annoying. As you can see, I just demoed a nice little thing right there where you can shoot the gun out of their hand to disarm them, like I've mentioned a couple times before. But it is possible for them to just walk over and pick it back up, which is really cool. Just, like, subtle details that people take for granted now, but was so incredibly revolutionary for the time. Just amazing. The other guy. Oh, yes. Son of a gun. I want to get rid of those guys. There's another elevator off to the side here, which is where all the firepower will be going. But of course, there's still another guy up here. No. Stay open. Stay open. Okay, or not. Oh, there's two guys up here. Good lord.
My gun.
There we go. All right. So let's shoot and kill that guy. Now we gotta go down. The first little bit of the mission starts out a little bit sluggish. But the really fun part is seeing how long you can go without being detected. That's what I find to be the fun part of this mission. Ooh, this guy has a shield. Nice. So as you can see with the shield, you get the second little health bar around your already existing health. I never really explained shield, but I mean, if you've played GoldenEye again with the body armor, it's the exact same sort of a concept. Okay, is it coming back down anytime soon or what? There we go. Good lord. Just like being in a real hotel or something, or a friggin' office. Ugh. I remember that at my internship all the time, how long it would take for the elevator to come down most times. And the worst part was is that there was a few days where they had the stores like closed off because they were just like putting in like new tiles or something for the stairs. And I had to take the elevator for those couple days, and I hate elevators because I have bad vertigo. And it just sucks, man. Just friggin' sucks. Not bad vertigo, not like an unhealthy case of it, but it's like, you know, it's enough to make me sick from high places. It's much more than just a fear of heights. All right. So as you can see, the spot that we're supposed to shoot has the little X marked. You know, see, Puss in Boots has been here. And all we do now is we just shoot the crate and we blow up the wall. And then you pick that up.
I don't have much time.
And ba-boom. Yeah. So then as soon as you put the disguise on that you get from killing the doctor by breaking down a wall beside them, you've completed the first objective.
Yes, have you?
So this is when you've hit sort of safe town. From here, what you can do is you can sort of go rogue even while you're in disguise, and you can start beating up all these guys if you want to. But of course, the safer approach. We're doing the safe route right now. I'll show you guys what the crazy route is next. This friggin' guy. Yeah. So you'll come in here, and you're still in disguise, but as soon as you walk over to this one guy, this friggin' tattletale, it's an intruder! And it's like, oh crap! So you gotta run in here, and you gotta open this up, and you gotta disarm this guy and beat him up and crap. Wherever he is. Ugh. Oh yeah, he's got a new weapon too called the tranquilizer. There we go. I'll explain more on the tranquilizer, in the next episode, because that's when it's actually being used and stuff like that. There we go. Whoa. Now there's a doctor. Alright, you really gotta watch out for the tranquilizers, though. I won't explain the effects here right now, but, it's not fun. We also picked up a new weapon called the Super Dragon. Now this is a nice weapon. Oh, God! Oh, I mean, that's a pretty predictable effect when you really talk about it. Yeah, the tranquilizer, you know. This is what the tranquilizer does to you. It puts you at a maximum dizziness with one shot. And it's not a very powerful weapon, but, you know, it's there to be annoying, pretty much. Oh, okay. I'm just running for my friggin' life here. Opening doors, dodging bullets by standing still. Alright, let's get the next one in this again. Alright. Whoa. Who had the tranquilizer, by the way? Good lord. I'm getting shot at in all directions now. Alright, time to show off the secondary function of the Super Dragon. The grenade launcher. If I could hit this guy. This one guy! There we go. He's just barely outside of the proximity of the explosion. So he gets out completely scot-free, apparently. Alright, here we go. Man, dude, these friggin' laboratories, man. Brings back so many memories, just of when I first played this and crap. Just nuts. Alright, just for the memo as well, all these guards will now know that you're an imposter. Like, so even though they're not moving anywhere or anything like that, it's, you know, you're still not protected. Everyone, it's like a global alert now. So now, it's just the only thing you can do is run for it. And kill people, of course. Oh, God. Friggin' sedatives. Sedating me and stuff. Where's this guy? Man, he's playing smart. Look at that. Well, he didn't play smart for much longer, but hey. Oh my God, look at that friggin' blur effect. Next gen, dude. Friggin' nuts. All right. Here's where the rush really gets going here. There we go. Gotta kill the guy closest to the door. He's got a key. You gotta open the doors and run your way in. And there you go, that's the mission.
Put hands up and step away from the alien. Don't make me tell you again, Doctor. And turn that laser off.
Oh man, dude, they were really getting ready. Alright, we unlocked the X-ray scanner, which is pretty cool. Now, we're of course going to decline the new mission, and we're going to replay the previous one. Because now I'm going to show you guys how to go about doing this mission. And I would argue that it's an easier way, especially if it's your first time playing. especially if you're doing a two-controller run. Good lord, this is just annoying. So, let's say you wanted to not use this cube. Actually, for a more realistic situation, let's say you were in the onslaught with guards, and you accidentally blew up the cube, right? So we failed the third objective, as we can see, if we open our menu. Rescue the crash survivor is apparently failed, because we can't blow open the wall anymore. But, as a lot of you can probably guess, there's a rather obvious second way you can do this, especially if you've really been paying attention to each gun's alternate abilities and such, and the like. Okay, time to take out these guys. Oh man, I'm really not good with this two controllers. It makes aiming a lot harder. I thought it was gonna make it easier, but I think it's just because of the other controller I have set to the other joystick. There we go. Is he dead? Okay, cool. Okay, and you're still around. Whoa, buddy! I was like, whoa, man, be reasonable! And then he just blows himself up. Are you serious right now? Oh my lord. Oh, I didn't show this off either in the previous playthrough here. Yeah. I'll show this off. Oh my god, as soon as we take care of these guys. Jeez. Hey, bend over in front of me, that's right. I'm the master. Yeah, so if you blow up this little thing in here, you do risk alerting guards if you're trying to play stealthy, but if you can get in here, you'll unlock another Falcon 2 silenced, which is really nice. Especially when you're still trying to get through this level in a sort of stealthy kind of way, you know? It really helps out. I'm looking around just to see if I can find any more dragons flying around. Yep, more people shooting. Good lord. Alright. Oh, one step ahead of me. Good lord! Whoa. Oh, are you up here? Where are you? He is too. Is that him? There he is. Man, you got great aim. Glad you're in Area 51 protecting this place. Good lord. Ooh! Don't want to miss that. Perfect. So we're already moving up to the next section. I'm being incredibly slow because, man, this control scheme really switches it up. Like, for those of you that have played through Perfect Dark before, this is a really nice way to sort of switch up the difficulty a little bit. Okay, come on. There we go. All right. Is that all of them? Is everyone dead? I don't know. Let's find out. Let's get this thing to come on down. Come on now. Are they gonna start shooting? Yep! Oh my god! Oh, nice. Alright. Oh my god. Oh, what a way to go. Oh my god. I didn't even shoot you in the chest. I shot you in the neck and like... Oh, I thought you can just like keep painting them with their own blood. Love that. You like... You can be a jerk too and just like... Shoot their head. Oh! Wait. Sorry. Yeah, open up. Sorry, elevator. Alright, cool. So we're up to the spot where you're supposed to have the explosive box armed so that you can blow it up right in front of the wall. Now, what you can actually do is, of course, using the dragon's secondary ability, you can use the proximity self-destruct to throw it down on the ground next to the explodable wall, and you can just take your silencers and shoot at it. If I can, again, if I can do that. Look how shaky I am. Good lord. I'm great at this game. I'm great. Where did another guy come from? Get out of here. Yeah, I can even go back and pick up his dragon if I want to. How good is that? That's pretty sweet. If I can... Good lord. Look at this thing! There we go. Alright, I had to shoot at it like 50 million times. There we go. I might switch up my my controllers. Like which controller's doing what. There we go. I'm just shooting at these guys right now. Get the hell out of here. I've already shot at you like a billion times. There we go. Alright, so we'll throw on the lab clothes. And ba-boom! So it says objective one is now completed, even though we technically failed the mission. Here we go. I'll see if it shows off the bug this time. Interesting. So you see, we went from incomplete, failed, to complete. Though sometimes, under some circumstances, you can actually bug out the game, and it will say objective 3 is incomplete on the screen. And you can still technically beat the mission while it's doing that, though. I don't know why. It makes me think that there are some missions that are, like, pivotal. That are, like, programmed to be pivotal missions, so it doesn't even matter how the other missions are. Like, as long as you didn't fail any other missions, you can complete the major ones. I don't know. It's a very strange little bug that they have. Everyone's been waiting for you. And then I always like doing this. I like to do this. And I just shoot him. And I just running guns a-blazing. It's an intruder! I'm like running in with a gun and that's all he has to say. It's an intruder! There we go, shoot him, kill him. We got a tranquilizer. You know? It's the name of the new evolution item for Tranquil. See, it's legit. No! Frank, don't focus all your fire on me. God damn! Area 51 guys! I know that they're the ones armed with guns and crap, but they're not important. Is there another guy in here? There isn't. See, now I'm all disoriented. I have no idea what I'm looking at. I'm just kind of eyeballing it now. There we go. I love this grenade launcher, though. It's so useful. She's like, oh yeah, for a few missions, let's just give you, like, the strongest practical weapon in the game. I'm like, oh, what a great idea, man. Not even being, like, you know, sarcastic or anything when I say that. I sincerely love the idea. Because it's just satisfying to blow people the hell up. In a lab coat, no less. Pretty sweet, man. There we go, blow that guy up. Look at this guy running for it. What is he doing? What are you doing, you silly goose? Alright, we'll blow that up too, because there's a guy there. There we go. Blow him up. See, I used to be, like, have amazing aim with this grenade. Like, I used to be able to just, like, look at somebody where they were, and I would know exactly where to position my gun. Just one of the things of being, like, 9 years old, I guess. I was a freaking wizard in this game. I mean, I also can't show you the full skills because I'm also handicapped with a very strange, but still oddly workable control scheme. But there we go. We just beat the mission by failing and then completing it somehow. I can only imagine like what what Carrington and Jonathan say when you get back to the HQ.
Don't make me tell you again, Doctor.
Carrington's probably like, first you blow up my wine. Then you blow up the crate we provide you. He's like, Joanna, do you have any idea how much government money you just wasted? Jonathan's probably just like, Oh man, jeez, Joe, you're so good. Man, wish I could be as good as you, Joe. And then I'm just like, shrugging face. Anyway, we are done for this episode. We've peaked in at about 20 minutes. Perfect. Not bad for the pacing. In the next episode, we're going to do the final one in the arc. We're going to do Area 51 Escape. This is a friggin' crazy mission. It moves very fast. So I'm not even sure if I'm going to be able to keep up with it commentary-wise. I'll try my best. But there are a couple very pivotal moments where if you make one mistake in a small amount of time, you could end up failing the whole mission, and it sucks. Anyway, I'll have some more stories to tell about this mission in the next episode. But until then, I hope you all have a very good life, or afterlife if you're the like pre-companion cube looking to get revenge on me in the next episode. Maybe it'll throw me in the incinerator. Oh, snap. Oh, timely reference, Will. I hate Portal. Peace.